What's going on, guys? Here's the deal. Premiere Pro works pretty well with the After Effects, especially with the linked media. However, I had in Premiere Pro S-Log3 footage from my Sony camera, and when I rendered the footage in After Effects as a composition, the colors are completely off and it was a hell to get them right. I went through like thousands of forums and couldn't find it. I did find some workaround. It was not perfect, but I have a solution. Let's jump right into it now. So guys, as you can see, all of this footage is pure S-Log3. And as I was telling in the previous video, you can just automatically set it to be converted to Rec. 709. That's super easy. All you have to do is to go to the color, under Lumetri, go to settings, select your clips, and you need to use media color space, and then all of the clips automatically for the project will be converted, as well as show that your working color space, in my case is Rec. 709 and auto tone map media. But if I want to render replace this clip with After Effects composition, in After Effects the clip looks like an S-Log, and I try to do what I would do in also in Premiere Pro. I would right click interpret footage and go to main and try to find under color something working here, but the problem is I can't select much here and cannot select the working space. So what I read is that actually I can do a bunch of stuff in the project settings. So that's where you need to go. You go to File, Project Settings, and under Project Settings, there is another color tab, which is funny, but here we go. So right here, the working color space is set to none. And in my case, since I was shooting with the Sony's S-Log3 and specifically S-Gamma 3, so that's exactly what I need to select. Once I hit OK, then the colors are I think they're way too saturated. And as I was editing this particular video, if in case you hit OK in this project setting colors tab and nothing changes, all you have to do is right click on your clip, interpret footage, go to main, and of course on the color tab, and here it pre-selects already the Rec. 709, God knows why. You have two options here. You can either scroll down and select your Cine S-Log3 and you see the footage is being converted, or the other option, you can just tick this preserve RGB, disable color management conversion for this item. I'm not sure why it happens, but it works either way, and that's it. And so let's see how it looks like in Premiere Pro. It looks like that. And if I throw an adjustment layer on top, it looks better. Here I'm gonna do a comparison of how the same adjustment layer, just so you know, I'm gonna do the same adjustment layer with the original clip that is converted to Rec. 709. It looks like that. Okay, and here it looks like this. So you can see the highlights and everything is a little bit, in my opinion, a little bit too much. My suspicion is that I still haven't figured out the auto tone map media in After Effects, because look, if I would have auto tone map media switched off here, then it's pretty bright. Here is the same brightness. If you guys know how to auto tone map media in the After Effects, let me know.
And that's about it, guys. I really hope this was helpful in some way. If you have a better solution, please let me know down in the comments. I would love to learn something new. Subscribe if you haven't already for more tutorials and a bunch of other type of videos. I'll catch you all in the next video. Don't forget to keep on creating.